So in this lesson, we're going to be looking at how to improve the IPC with out-of-order execution and how to design actual hardware that does that. For improving the IPC, we have seen that the ILP can be good. It can be significantly larger than one. Usually it's way over four. But to achieve something close to that ILP, we need to handle the control dependencies. And we have seen how branch prediction can help eliminate control dependencies if branch prediction is correct. So if our branch prediction is very good, which on today's processors it is, then as far as control dependencies are concerned, our IPC will be very close to the ILP. Then we have to consider the write-after-write and write-after-read data dependencies, also known as false dependencies, and we have seen that a technique called register renaming can completely eliminate these dependencies so that you simply don't have them anymore in your program, at which point they're not going to be a problem for our IPC. And then we have seen that there are these write-after-read, also known as true data dependencies, and we have seen that it helps a lot when you can execute instructions out of order, meaning you don't strictly follow the program order, you simply find instructions whose inputs are ready and you execute them then. That is how ILP mostly was good. And finally, there are these structural dependencies, which is when you cannot execute things simply because you don't have enough resources in the processor, but that can be solved simply by investing into a wider issue processor, meaning we need a processor that can handle a bunch of instructions in each cycle and not have to delay instructions just because it doesn't have resources for it. So among these, we really need to figure out how to do these three, and first we will focus on this. So how do we actually do register renaming and out-of-order execution in a way that can be amenable to hardware implementation? So we know how to do it kind of manually on paper, but how does a processor actually do it? So this lesson will really focus on how to do this for real.